In this tutorial, we will learn how to use mesh morphing to alleviate the stress concentration in this blade component. The pressure loading condition and constraint that are simplified the load case are explained in this representation. You can have a look to the computational mesh, and you can see that we have enough resolution on the fillet area, and we can see also the result of the stress analysis, and in particular we want to see what is the maximum principal stress, that is the most critical for fatigue on the traction side. And you can see the hotspot region, in particular this one that can be better captured here. We want to reduce this stress concentration by using mesh morphing. To enable mesh morphing, we use RPF morph, and we have to decide how to tweak the shape of the component. In particular, for this fillet, an efficient way to reduce the stress concentration, where the peak occurs here, I show you again. Here we go, is to try to reduce the radius and to propagate the transition over a larger area. Mesh morphing can be used with this effect. So if you think this as a 2D problem on a cross section, we can think to move the interface of the fillet upward in the airflow direction, and we can think to move the end of the fillet here inward and outward to change this radius and to change the shape. For this purpose, we have used RPF morph, and with RPF morph, we have introduced two shape parameters. I enable now RPF morph, it's already programmed, and for this kind of problem, the mesh is not that large, but it's overall a mesh comprised of 430,000 nodes. The best way is to limit the morphing action just in the fillet area. To do that, we can use named selection or a direct selection of nodes. In this case, we have used a direct selection of nodes, so the nodes that are morphed are represented in the picture. Here you can see an enlarged view of the morphing area. To limit the morphing action, we have also manually defined a fixed area at the end of the morphing region, a fixed area at the other end, and furthermore we have also fixed some faces, and we can preview what will be the action on the nodes we want to take preserved. And the core of this morphing action is the control of the fillet surface. The fillet surface, that is this one, has been controlled acting on the upper edge, that in this case is moved up, and on the lower edge, that in this case is extruded outward or inward, using a curve offset in that case and a simple translation operator in this other. In this one, the two modifications will be combined and produce an RPF that will be propagated to the fillet. The fillet action on the nodes will be this one. This fillet action plus the fixed face, the fixed up area, and the fixed down area will control the morphing domain, so will propagate the deformation. The effect of the deformation can be inspected by pressing the morph command. You can see now the morphed mesh. We can go back and forth to appreciate the effect of the morphing. And if we solve now with RBF morph enabled, the stress solution will be conducted on the morphed mesh. Once an analysis is completed, we can expect the results, and in this case we can see that the stress peak has been reduced, and furthermore we can appreciate how the area with the maximum stress is now wider. So we have distributed the stress concentration over an higher area. I will show you now how this model can be transformed into a parametric one. We have just to reset the mesh onto the original configuration, and we can simply decide what are the parameters. In this case, we restore this to zero and we select this as a parameter, and at the same time here we select the offset value to zero and we create this as a parameter. We want to have as parameter the maximum principal stress that can be enabled here. Once the parameters are created, we can interact with them. Here you can see the results of a manual interaction with the model. You can see that the baseline that is set as the current design point is 0,0 for the two parameters, and you can change the two inputs parameter, in this case 1, 2, 3 up to 4 for the upward movement of the fillet, and also moving back and forth to see the effect of a positive and negative action. The best result is achieved going to 4 millimeters and 0.5 millimeters. In the full automatic approach, we have added the response surface optimization block. The response surface optimization block allows to have an automatic variation of the parameters. In this case, we have used the design of experiment, and the set of experiment is defined controlling the number of points and the range in which we are working. You can see here the table generated. This is already completed run. Using this, you can also cross-process, so you can use the response surface, in this case a response plot in which we plot the maximum stress. We can manually investigate this process, or a radar, we can decide to go for a totally automatic approach. So you can see that if you go for the total automatic approach, we'll allow to tell that we want, in this case, minimize the maximum principal stress. And so, using the response surface, you can go for the minimization. The minimization will retrieve a certain number of candidates. Such candidate can be recomputed, and so you can go for the best solution. In this case, we have identified this minus 0.5 and 4 as a very good solution for our problem. Once we have completed the optimization, we can reconstruct the cut. We generate in mechanical a certain number of named selection. That is, we create a named selection of nodes for each phase of the original cut. This can be obtained automatically using a specific script. Once we have this, if we deliver the model to FEM modeler, FEM modeler will automatically detect the skin that will be the one defined using the named selection principle, and will attempt to reconstruct the geometry, that is this one, and we can create a parasolid representation. And the new geometry can then be imported, as in this example, in a new DM block, as you can see in this example. And here you have the new working geometry. And this concludes the tutorial. Many thanks for your attention.